Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Welcome to today's session. So you're joining the Postman API challenge, and this is a session where we're going to walk you through our Postman collection, and we're going to show you how you can get it started and run some API requests using our Postman collection. In this session, though, there's going to be a bit of a fun twist. We have Arlemi from Postman joining us, and we're going to be doing a blindfold challenge. Arlemi, it's really nice to have you. Do you want to tell us how this session is going to work?
Basically, I do not know anything about that session. I'll try to look for how can I use the Postman collection for DocuSign. You'll give me a few challenges of things that you need to build with, and hopefully I'll be able to do it in front of your eyes and maybe even follow along.
Yeah, so to be clear, Arlemi has never played with our Postman collection before. It is his first time doing it alongside you guys. And if you guys want to follow along with him and pull up our Postman collection, then you guys can come along this ride with us. So just a quick note, the agenda today, we only have 40 minutes with you guys. So this is going to be a very quick session. We're going to quickly do some introductions. Then we're going to jump right into the API challenge. And let me remind you that we're going to have an Ask Me Anything session coming up in half an hour. So if you don't get to ask many questions by the end of the session right now, don't worry about it. Don't fret it. You have the opportunity to ask the questions. Yeah, and that's all I had. So let me tell you about myself. My name is Nima. I'm a senior software engineer at DocuSign. My primary responsibilities is all the SDKs that DocuSign releases. We have eSignature, Notary, Monitor, Rooms, and all these products, and every product comes with its own SDK for 5 languages. And my primary responsibility is improvement and release of these SDKs, but I've done some work in the past with our Postman collections, which is what would bring me here today. Now, let me also ask you, Arlemi, can you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Sure. So my name is Arlemi. I'm a senior developer advocate at Postman. And as you guess, I shouldn't have any issues with the Postman side of that challenge. But part of my responsibilities is working with partners, making sure that they know what to make with Postman and how to make things available for their users, which is what Nima has done with someone else on my team. But now we're going to see what they've built and how to use it.
Yeah, and Arlemi is joining us from Europe. So it's exciting to have all the different time zones on one call. Anyways, and with that, let's jump right into it. All right, so I'm going to stop sharing, and Arlemi, take us away. Show us your screen.
We'll put up. Cool. Can you confirm you're seeing the DocuSign API challenge workspace?
I do. Yeah, let's do it.
Cool. Perfect. So a bit of context. I've created that workspace right before this call. That's where I'm going to try to do everything. And if you want to follow along, you can do the same thing on your PC. If you just want to see what I'm doing, this is a public workspace. So if you look for DocuSign API challenge, you should be able to find it and you can just see what's happening. So first thing first, I know there's a DocuSign collection. That's a good thing. So should I start with that and try to find it?
Actually, before we're going to start, how do you create a workspace? Okay. Do you just go through the menu and just create a new workspace?
Is this how I can start from the very beginning. So that's when you log into Postman, you land on your homepage. You have some like quick links to create a new workspace, for example, a new collection, et cetera, some information or like useful links. There's a few different ways to create a new workspace, but the one that I use mostly is going to the workspace menu at the top and then creating a new workspace here. So that's what I did. I probably could have done it during this call, just gave it a name, gave it a type of visibility, but I did that already. So I'm just going to switch to this one and that's what I'm going to use.
Yeah, I bring this up because I noticed if you start with the default workspace, you can never make that public and make pull requests.
Yeah, and true.
So it is important to call out, create your own workspace. Do not use the default if you want to contribute. Yeah. All right, to your next question. Yeah, so we do have a public workspace with our Postman collections. And if you just Google that, I think that should come up. I can send you a link, but let's try the old
I'll try to find it. DocuSign.
Public.
Postman? Let's see. Here. Please, Mr. Postman. So that's probably not the one.
That's not the one.
But I can see this one, which is Postman DocuSign. So go for this one. And I'm guessing that's your profile.
Yeah, this is us. Awesome. Awesome. So you see, we only have one workspace that is public and we have five collections, right?
Yep.
So let's go to our workspace and let's fork our collection.
Okay. So in your workspace, there's a few ones. Is there a specific one I should fork?
Yeah, let's focus on eSignature because that's our most popular. So yeah, right there. Yeah.
So a few ways you can fork a collection, either going through the menu here, creating a fork, or you can click on it, open it, and then you have like the, oh, okay. It's already a few people that forked it. So I'm going to go ahead, give it a name. So I'll call it DocuSign Challenge, and I'll fork it in my DocuSign API Challenge workspace. There's this option here. If I want to be made aware of whenever like Nima updates a collection or whenever there's an update to the API, I can keep that ticked. And I will, because it's always valuable to know when there's changes to an API. So yeah, let's give it a sec. It should fork, redirect me to my own workspace, and then we can start playing with it. Cool. I have it all in my workspace now.
That's great. So now here's something that we actually have to do before we start. So if you go back to our public workspace, so there is an environment as well that when you fork, the environment doesn't fork away, right? Yeah, so if you go under environments, so here what we have to do, so if you look at it, see, we have all these parameters that need to be defined. And right now the workaround that we have is we manually export this environment and then we import it back into the fork that you just did.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you go to the three ellipses on the top right-hand corner, right next to share. Yeah, export. There we go.
Can I not just fork it to my
good
workspace?
Question. Yeah, actually, I've never done it that way.
I think that's probably easier. Okay. So the same way you can fork a collection, you can now fork environment. So I'll do that, fork it in the same workspace. And now, so I'm back in my DocuSign API Challenge. I have the collection here and I have the environment here. So I can do that all just through the forking mechanism.
Yeah, that's perfect. So, all right, I'm asking some questions on the side. So don't mind if I get a little bit distracted. Exactly. So of all these parameters, the ones that we really have to specify is iKey, iSecret, and encoded keys, right?
Okay.
So let's hop over to your DocuSign admin dashboard.
So yeah, I created that account before as well. So that should be a brand new account. I think here I get to the admin page. So I get there and I should see some credentials, I believe.
Yeah, perfect. So exactly. So you don't have any integrations right now. So let's go ahead and create one for our session today.
Does this need to be like a unique name?
In your space, yeah. But
okay, that's fine then.
That's perfect. Okay, so for authentication, we're going to use authentication code ground for today, but we also have JWT that we have a lot of material for. So let's go ahead and add a secret key right there. And let's copy that bad boy before we lose it, okay?
Yeah.
Perfect. So also let's just scroll down. We also have to specify our redirect URI. So here I usually just specify, you know, https://example.com, which is just the, you know, example.
The default, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Okay, example.com, yeah, sure. And that's it, let's save that. All right, since you have the secret key copied, let's go back to the Postman collection environment. Yeah, so iSec refers to the security key.
Okay, so I'm in a public workspace. I don't want anyone that sees that public workspace to access that key. So I'm gonna use the current value, which is not shared. If you use the initial value, then anyone that visits that workspace actually has access to that data. So I will avoid making my API key public.
That's a really good call out. And I think Postman should even like give you a pop-up, like tell people like, this is public, do not do it there. Like this is catastrophic.
Yeah.
Anyways, so iKey is your integration key. So let's go back to the admin
dashboard. Oh wait, it's iKey, I put it in iSec.
No, the secret, is that, No, I think this was the secret you copied, right?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, so that's the secret. So the integration key is like
it's this one.
That's right. Okay. Yeah.
That makes sense. Okay.
Okay. So the next variable that we need is the encoded keys. So that's essentially your integration key colon your secret, but is base64 encoded.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's go to some online like base64 encoder. Not the safest thing in the world, but there's some,
yeah.
There's some good ones. This is a safe one. Okay.
So you said it's.
So it is your one. Yeah, integration key.
Integration key, colon.
Colon, your secrets.
Secret.
Yeah.
And then.
That's encoded.
Okay, so that should be it.
That should be it. Yeah.
Yep. Here.
Perfect. So let me quickly call out one thing. So using the public workspaces is great because it's a very interactive process and you make pull requests, but you do have to do these manual steps yourself. But if you go and download our Postman collection directly from our website, we populate all of that for you automatically. But on the other hand, you never get that interactive experience with your teammates. So it's always a trade-off. If you're just trying to quickly get it started, I recommend just downloading directly from our website. But we recommend that everybody use this approach for most of the cases because we want to get pull requests from people.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Perfect. So this is already saved. So now let's go back to our collection. Now we're ready to get started, right? So the very first thing you want to do is to get an access token before I can give you a challenge. So if you look at our authentication, we looked at the code grant, authorized code grant. Yeah. Now if you look at, yeah, we should select the environment. That helps. Yes.
Perfect. Now it resolves. Yep.
And if you look at the body, okay, so we still need something called a code from URL, right? So in order to do that, we need to construct a URL that will go and authorize the application that we just created, okay?
Okay.
So here's the URL. So you may want to, I wish there was a way to copy paste this for you. Actually, I'll just copy paste it in your chat, Arlemi. But essentially, there are some variables that we have to go and replace. So essentially you go to our auth endpoint, which is account-d.docusign.com/oauth, and we ask—
Oh, you want me to actually access that URL, okay.
But you have to replace the client ID with yours.
Okay.
Yeah, and that should be it.
So client ID is this one, and client ID I get it from—
That's the just integration key. So,
okay, the integration key for this one.
Here we have multiple names for the same thing.
Okay, so I'll replace that like this. Okay. Actually, should I change that to be /redirect or?
Yeah, you should actually. That's okay. A good point. So now I should prompt you. It's not registered properly.
Let's see. Client ID and then redirect is, I'll double check how I configured it.
Yeah, maybe get rid of the redirect at the end of example.
Yeah. Yep. Save. And then just make sure this is the right one. Okay.
Uh-huh. Redirect. Yeah, there we go.
Oh. It's not registered.
That is weird. So let me— Okay, why don't you send me your account ID? I'll do it on my end. I'll just send you the code for URL.
Okay. Yep.
All right, 1 second.
Oh, is it because I had 3 W's here? Might have been.
Oh, I think I know what's going on. I think usually it takes a few seconds for it takes a few seconds for the the code, the redirect to be registered.
Okay.
I've actually encountered this before. So hold on, let me see if there's a better way we can do this. Okay, so I'm gonna send you a code from URL for my account and we're gonna continue with that, okay?
Okay.
All right, so if you just copy and paste that into Postman.
Oh, I got it.
Oh, perfect. There we go. See, it just takes time.
I know. I didn't. Never mind.
Oh, no, it is. It is. It is. No, you're right. You didn't get it. That's fine. So let's copy whatever I gave you. And
so you want me to replace this?
Yeah. Put it in the environment. Yeah.
Yep. Code from URL, which is down here. Okay. So now I have.
Okay.
This.
Now let's run this. Yeah. Your client is not authorized. That's very strange. Hold on. Let me try this on my end. I wonder what is going on. These are the fun things about doing things live, right?
Yep. Gonna keep on trying on my end. Let's see if I manage to get it.
Okay, 1 second. Okay, I mean, if it doesn't work for you, I can share my screen and show it. I think what's going on with you is like it takes a few minutes for your new account to be populated. So that is just taking some time. Okay?
Yep. I'll let you share if you want.
Okay. So let me share my screen and we'll take it from here.
I'll keep on trying in the background just in case I can.
Yeah, yours is gonna eventually gonna pop in, but it might take a few seconds. Okay, so the only thing that changed between Arlemi environment and mine is that, you know, my account has been baked over 24 hours. So a lot of those things are already populated. So I just copied my quote from URL. Where is it? Yeah, it is somewhere. So I just copied the quote URL that I give Arlemi and I ran it. I got a new access token. Now, the good thing is that our Postman collection will automatically go and save that access token inside of one of our variables. So going forward, you don't have to like copy this manually and paste it in every request. So once you have your access token, the very next thing you want to do is you want to populate the rest of the parameters that we have. There are things like the API version and then your OAuth base path. And these are all the things like your account ID actually. So these are the things that need to be populated before we can send any requests. And so if you just go ahead and run this request after you got the access token, as you can see, we get all the information that you need to get started. Your base URI and your account ID, everything is there. And we just grab it and we copy it. So at this point, once you do this, now you're ready to start using our Postman collection. And this is where I was going to give Arlemi a really hard time because I picked out some really complicated scenarios. But yeah, he gets off the hook easy today, which is fine. There are a few things I want to tell you. So when you look at our Postman collection, it looks a little bit intimidating. So if you look at something as simple as creating an envelope, like you're going to see this gigantic list of options that you can provide. And at first it could be really intimidating to even know where to start. So the reason why this is happening is because, we create our Postman collection from Swagger files. And these Swagger files have the models that provide all the possible options. And these collections that we provide, they're supposed to be a starting point for you, but they're never going to be easy and straightforward to send right away. If you want to get it started, we have this other folder called examples. So in the examples folder, what we've done is we have trimmed down all these gigantic models to the absolute bare minimum that you need to provide before we can get started. So in this case, all we're doing is we provide a document. We just have an email and the name and we send it, right? So let's try some of these and see if we can send an envelope. There you go. So just like that. And if you look at it in the environment, we had to specify the user one, I guess it doesn't show up in the environment. But if you just look at the email that we have provided here, right? So in this case, we're just using a dummy Mailminator email, which I guess, again, not the safest thing in the world. But if you change this again, this will actually go to your mailbox. So you can actually see the envelope that we just sent. And we have also listed 20 other scenarios of some of the more popular things that you can do with our eSignature APIs. And if you just go through them, every previous step will populate the parameters that you need for the previous step. So for example, we have something called get envelope status, right? So we just created an envelope here and it was put in the created status. So if you now we get the status, now it should also be that status was sent. So it just populated everything from the previous step down to the new one. Now, Arlemi, how are you doing on your side? Is it still erroring up for you, or how are we doing?
Yeah, it's actually still giving me the something went wrong. So I'm wondering if, I don't know, maybe I'll just recreate one and see if that works better.
Yeah, it is. It is interesting. And you copied your encoded keys properly, right? You did integration key colon. Secret.
Secret
key.
Right? Yep. 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 Yep.
Okay. Yeah, I'm just trying to look at mine and see if there's anything you're missing. So you have the key, you have the security, and you have the encoded keys, right?
Yep.
And your account ID is listed there too.
Account ID might not be there actually.
Actually, account ID is populated for you automatically, so that shouldn't be a problem. Is your account alive? Like, is the app that you have? Because I'm going to show you my app here. Let's try and see if there's any difference between yours and mine. So you have auth key and you have one secret key, right?
Yep.
And you have example.com, right?
And I have example.com, yep.
And that's the HTTPS, right?
It is HTTPS.
Okay. I still think the thing that is holding you up is just maybe take some time for the account to be populated. So that's the only thing that I can think of right now.
So is yours live? Mine is not live. I don't know if to do that. Okay.
Yeah. So live is when you go from demo
to production,
yeah. Right?
Okay.
All right. So while we give Arlemi a little more time and maybe his account will populate by then, is I'll go through a few other scenarios that we have. So we have some things like getting the document from the envelope as well. And this is something that I love about this Postman workspace. Like when you do this, like it is smart enough to know it's a file and actually displays a file for you. So you're not getting a bit of a, you know, jitter bytes that are just hanging in there. If you want to look at the documents in the envelope, but you just want a list of it, again, we have an example that would actually just give you the list, and it actually gives you a URI to the file as well. So you can just see the envelopes there. Something that's a little bit more challenging is creating a template. So right now, let's look at if you have any existing templates on my account. And I'm not sure if there's anything in there, but we'll see. Okay, there is. So when you create an envelope, there are really two ways you can do it. You know, you can provide, all these specific parameters directly to the envelope. And every time you create it, you have to do this all over again. But if you have a recording scenario that is happening, you can just create a template and then just provide the recipients on the fly. And this is an example that is actually very, very popular. And a lot of people actually run into problems with it. So I have a definition of a template right here. And as you can see, like we're just saying we have a document and then here are our recipients. And we should specify, where the tabs are on this document. And that's all the information that you provide. And after this template is created, every time you want to create an envelope with it, what you have to do is just provide the template ID. So if you look at the set envelope with a template, what you're seeing that like in this case, we're not providing any parameters to the envelope anymore. All we're giving it is a simple template ID, which is something that we created before. And from this, it is able to just go and send the envelope directly for us, okay? We only have 6 minutes left. I think I want to spend the last 6 minutes with you, Arlemi. Like, I do want to try to get your situation to work, or at least understand what may be going wrong.
Yep.
So do you want to take over the screen again, and let's try and debug your situation?
So I'll show you. I've been told there's some people trying to help in the Q&A. I can't see the Q&A, but thank you.
I've created
a new one, created a new base64, updated my environment. One thing that I do not have account ID because I forked, right? I did not export the environment.
Yeah. Well, actually, you know what? Let's try something. Let's go and get the Postman collection directly from our website and let's see if that will make a difference. Okay.
Okay. So
let me send you a link. There we go. Okay. All right. Yeah, if you click sit on an environment, now put in your integration key.
Yep. So we'll take the new one just in case.
Okay.
Secret key, I have it here. Environment demo API v2.1.
Create the environment. Yep. Okay. Now just click run in Postman. Yep. No.
Okay. I'll put it in here and yeah, leave that to default. At least I can make the difference. Yep. Okay. So that's the one that comes in with the pre-populated environment, which hopefully should remove the human error from the loop.
Human error will be removed. Yeah. No,
so we still have I'll remove this one just so there's no.
Sounds good. Now we still have to get you a code from that URL, which maybe where we're going wrong. So let's try that again. Let's see if we can finally get a code from that URL.
Okay. So I'll get the URL you send me. I'll do it in here just for the edit so we can see what I'm doing. So client ID should be the integration key. So I'll go here, grab the integration key and paste it here.
Correct.
And then this should be the correct one already. Get this. Okay.
Yes. All right. Allow access. Yes, you have the code. There you go.
Okay, just needed to try harder.
Was it a copy and paste thing? Now I'm a little bit baffled.
It may have been. Because I don't think there was like a much longer time between when I created that one or the other one. So it must have been some problem between the keyboard and the chair. Something like that.
All right, so let's put the code and URL in your collection.
So this one is called code URL.
Code from URL.
Code from URL. Okay. Let's see. With authentication, this one. Ah,
it's actually, yeah.
Yep.
There we go. Let's send this and hopefully you should get a access token.
Could not found. Ah. Did I not save the environment? Yep.
Yeah.
Okay.
There we go. Very nice. All right. Now get user info, request number 4. Yeah. Perfect.
Okay. That's me.
There you go.
I'm authenticated. We did it. That was the challenge. Challenge was to get authenticated. Yeah,
you got a poke easy today. We only have 2 minutes. So let's see if you've been listening. Can you send us a very simple envelope with nothing fancy, just an envelope?
I can try. Actually, it's not in envelopes, in examples. Yeah. I can create an envelope. I was doing some stuff on the side as well because I was trying to debug. So let's see. I don't think this needs anything from here. Let's see. If I send this, invite request body. So I do need to update.
Need a document. So I'll send that to you. Again, inside our environment collection, we do have the document already populated. Oh yeah, and it's way too big for letting me send it to you. So you have to go to our public collection and then you just have to copy the environment from there.
This one.
Yeah.
And then from the environment or from here?
Just from the environment.
Okay. Document is this one. And I can add that to my own environment. Oop, that's, is that the one?
Hold on, go back.
Getting confused now.
Yeah. So document.
Yeah, wait. That's the one. I just need to create it here. Okay.
Right. All right, let's try this again. Invalid is missing, malformed. Is it because
it needs document ID as well?
Document ID, yeah, actually it does. You do need to provide that. Yeah, let's just provide 123 or something. Nothing big.
Okay, I'll just change it directly in the in here, unless there's different references now.
Yeah, just put it there, yeah. Maybe it has to be in quotes, like do a string, like 134. Hold on. Start with recipient's ID.
Missing.
Email. Actually, yeah, what is the email that you're using?
That's probably not, it's probably missing from the environment as well, right? Like all of these must be missing.
Exactly.
Yeah. So I need to hard code it. Yep. I can do that. Can even do random email. Can do random name. And then is this, that's a string, right?
That's correct, yeah.
Oop.
Okay.
We're passing value empath.
Request body is missing, probably email. So what is the email again? Is this correct email?
So I'm sending a random email from like the old via or library that generates random things, but I can do.
Yeah, it needs to be a real email, I think, because I think the backend will. It
needs to be a natural one.
Yeah, yeah. I think it has to be a proper email, but everything else could be random. Yeah.
Do that.
Okay.
Let's make that lorem ipsum send.
Actually, the ID may have to be a number, I think. So
I think now it's complaining about the name. It did pass the email.
Okay. So let's try that as well.
Okay. And now our recipient ID is missing. We're getting there. So that needs to be an ID. So that would be 134. Okay.
There we go. Perfect.
Create an envelope. It's already started sent.
Yeah. Right. So there's a difference, right? So when you say sent, like it will actually show up in your email, but if you put it in a draft, obviously, then you know you're waiting for final sending of the envelope.
Yep.
So we have about 10 minutes. So let me torture you with something a little bit harder now. Let's see. Now, why don't you try listing the documents in an envelope? Let's see how that's going to go.
So let's see. What if I do documents? Get a list of documents associated to a template.
Okay.
These documents in an envelope. Okay.
Yeah, that's the easiest one. So let's verify all these envelope.
Yeah, IDs. I'm gonna double check everything this time. We need an envelope ID. Which has been set from the previous request. That's good.
Yeah.
We have an access token, which is already defined. There's nobody. This is just a simple get. So I should be able to send that straight away. And you can tell me, have an envelope ID. It has a document ID. He has one page.
Uh-huh.
And then document type electronic. Okay.
Yeah. Cool.
And then... Yep.
Uh-huh. Now, what does this document look like? You know, so we have all this metadata, but how does it look like?
That's a certificate. And that's all I can... Okay, so it's... Is that in centimeters? No, that would be a lot. That would probably be millimeters?
That is in pixels.
Pixels. Okay, yeah. Pixels with a DPI.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and can I have a look at it?
Okay, so that's your challenge, right? So now you have a list of documents.
Okay.
Now we want to get the document, right? Get the document from envelope.
Okay. So let's have a look. So do I want to have a look at this one probably? Let me remove this and see if there's a get document.
Yeah, as a hint, example is always a good place to start.
Yeah, right? Get a document from envelope. Okay,
there you go.
Sounds like exactly what I'm trying to do. Base, account ID, envelope ID, document ID. This I will pull from here.
That's right.
That's my... So there's two different ones. My guess would be that it's this one because it's document ID.
Yeah, because you already have the envelope specified. So yeah.
So I'm gonna do doc ID, have it as a path parameter here, so it's easier to change. Then send this. Oh, okay. It's actually the preview here. That's cool.
That's really cool. Yeah.
Yeah, that is okay. I did not expect this to show up here. Usually when we wanna like show some stuff in there, we ask people to create a either visualizations, etc., but not like a direct. Is that a PDF actually?
It is a PDF. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's something we've added recently, actually. So that's a very good use of it.
Yeah, because I remember I used to get just the array of bytes
before. Yeah.
So now that's pretty cool.
So now we have like the preview of PDFs straight there. Okay.
Yeah. So we have literally 4 minutes. So let's do one quick thing, and then we're gonna open the floor just questions after that. So I need you to go ahead and create one template for me. And again, the secret is out of the genie bottle, so you know where to look.
Create a template with role only.
Okay, so let's look at the body and see what, exactly.
So this one needs a document. Is this one saved in my environment? Let me clear up this.
Think it is. We just said the document. Yeah, there we go.
Document. Okay, cool. Document ID. This one I do not have. Yeah, I'm going to add it here so it's easier. Document ID, which is 123. Email message, email subject. There's a comma here. It's complaining about already. Does this need to be a new ID or do I want the same one?
I think we'll just override it, so it should be okay.
Okay. Let's send. Okay.
Perfect. Okay, this opens a great segue. So you just found a problem with one of our requests where there was an extra comma hanging around and you got rid of it, right? So how do you contribute this change back to our main Postman collection?
Yeah, so I'll show the way. I'm not going to go all the way because I've done a lot of edits because I was rushing through. But now that I've found this bug, there's different ways. One thing I can do is just directly do a pull request. So I'll send that back to Nima's team or Nima directly. I'll say fixed extra comma in body. I could add some more descriptions, etc. But do not want to add a reviewer. That's going to be done automatically. And then I can see the review of my changes. So that's what I can do. But obviously, I've added stuff that should not make it to the official one. So that's one way to do it. The other way that I'm going to show quickly, so that's the DocuSign public workspace. And I know where it is. I know it's in examples. I know it's in create a template. So I can go in here, find this extra comma, which actually has been fixed in this one already, it seems. But what I could do is, that's the one, right? Create a template with role. Okay. I could just leave a comment directly here and say, hey, there's an extra comma here. And then they would get a notification, prompt them directly exactly where that this issue lies. They can fix it themselves instead of mid creating a pull request. So that's the two ways to do it.
That's awesome. Awesome. Yeah, so we only have a couple minutes left. So let me say thank you, Arlemi. Sorry to put you through all this.
That's all good. It's better. I'm better under stress, so it's all good.
Yeah. We learned that copy and paste can get you at all times. So that's the main takeaway. But having said that, we're going to open the floor to any questions that you guys have. And remember, we're going to have an Ask Me Anything session coming up at 12:30, which is in 20 minutes. So if you don't get to ask your questions, feel free to jump in 20 minutes. All right, let's see if any new questions come in.
Do you want me to leave that up or should I stop sharing?
Let's leave it up, see if there's a question where we can show them something, but.
Cool.
Okay, so I'm not seeing any new questions coming in. So our organizers want me to remind you that there are several buttons that you can use to navigate going forward. There's a take survey button at the top, and you know there's a button for the next session at the bottom as well. Other than that, yeah, thank you so much, everyone. I'll see you guys in 20 minutes to answer any questions that you have. And again, let me thank you, Arlemi, for joining us today and going through this challenge.
It was fun. Yeah, it was very fun. Thank you for the challenge, and thank you all for sticking along and trying to help in the Q&A as well.
Awesome. All right. Thanks, everyone. See you in 20 minutes. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye.